guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Faith. I am a completely self-taught tattoo artist, and today we're going to be talking about line work and voltage. So if you are interested in that, go ahead and stay tuned. If you are already subscribed and you are back, thank you so much for being here. If you're new, thank you so much for being here. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like, comment, let me know if you're from TikTok, let me know if you've ordered yourself a tattoo kit, which one you've ordered. I know that I have talked to so many of y'all in my inbox on Instagram. I'm gonna have all my other social medias linked below, so please go ahead and follow me there. First thing we are going to talk about is my machine that I'm going to be using today. All right, so this is the Atom. I have it pulled up on my laptop right here, so I'm gonna be looking this way to read to y'all some details. So this is the Dragonhawk Atom. It's a kit that comes with a cheap little power source, which, hold on, let me just show you, is one that I don't love per se. Comes with some needles, a shitty foot pedal that I don't recommend because these metal ones spark really easily. Let's see what else we got. Okay, it comes with a little box. Pretty much the best thing that you're getting is this rotary machine, but I've honestly been using this one for about a year now, and I love it. The only thing I didn't love, obviously, was the power source. I'm going to be doing a review of the power source I've been using that I finally found one that I love. And again, it's from Amazon. It's a cheaper brand. But this is what I'm going to be using today. And the first thing I'm going to do is put on some gloves, because I want y'all to get in the habit of putting on gloves, whether you're tattooing on fruits, fake skin, whatever it is. I want y'all to get in the habit of putting on gloves when you're touching your machine, as I'm touching my machine without gloves. Let me put on some gloves. All right, get my gloves on. If y'all are following, get yourself some gloves on. I need to buy myself another box of pink ones. These ones are actually nitrile because I had a client that was allergic, which will happen. All right, so I got my gloves on. I got my machine. Side note, never call this a gun. The best argument I've gotten is, I mean, they just say that, what did I say they said? They say, guns kill, machines create. I don't know, so that's why they're so mad if you call it a gun. You'll hear me still accidentally call it a gun. I'm trying to stop calling it a gun, but I grew up hearing it being called a tattoo gun, so I don't quite understand the big deal, but I will tell you that that is a thing that you don't want to do. But I mean, even if you're considering getting a tattoo kit off of Amazon, that's something that they're gonna hate you for. So I am putting on my machine cover. That is another thing that I want to strongly urge to y'all. I'm gonna be making another whole video about sanitization. And everything that I think you should need. I have this in the bio of previous videos where I tell y'all, you know, what I recommend y'all getting. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this up. Rana, these are $9.99. It was a 200 pack. Tattoo pen covers, again, if you're gonna spend the money, it's on Amazon, just do the measures to be sanitary and to do everything the safe way. Obviously, I'm gonna get them in pink if they come in pink. But yeah, so I slid this on the top and then have it sitting in one of the notches. So I'm gonna grab my grip tape, which comes in most of the kits that you can get on Amazon. I'm sorry, I'm gonna take these off. I just realized that the ring light is making that huge thing on them. So I apologize for that. But I'm gonna go ahead and put my grip tape at the bottom. That's gonna hold on the machine cover and also make it a lot more comfortable for you holding the machine. So let me go ahead and wrap this a couple times. Again, it's complete preference, but you'll figure out what's comfortable for you as you get used to it. All right, so now this is what we have. We have our machine cover, our grip tape, and now we're missing a needle. All right, so today this video is gonna be if you have the rotary pen style machine. Now if you have a coil machine, let me know in the comments and I'll do a whole video that is in regards to a coil machine. I have those needles as well. But today, for the sake of the fact that I've been using the Atom, I've been using the rotary pen, it's what I am preferring currently. So that's what I'm gonna be doing right now. With that being said, I have a few different needle sizes right now. Let me pull y'all in closer. Now, I've said it in multiple videos before that for the past couple years, I've been pretty much consistently using 7-round liners, unless I'm doing, you know, a particular style like a more American traditional that requires a thicker line. I just really like where 7-round liners land my line work. I also feel like I'm able to stipple with them, which it'll be a whole nother video on stippling, but as a disabled artist, I prefer stippling. I actually love how it looks, and it's a lot easier, a lot quicker, and that's how I prefer to do a lot of my shading. So right here I have a 3-round liner, and I just want to show y'all how small this is. So tip, anytime I'm tattooing somebody, I show them this package before anything is opened, because it comes with a sterilization date and an expiration date. So it's not required, but I always take that extra measure to just say, hey, I just wanted to show you this is a new needle, it's sterile, and then once they say, oh, okay, yeah, and read the date, I'll then proceed to open it. So that's what I'm gonna do now. Open this up. And I want y'all to see just how small that is. So for me, unless I had like a very, you know, small detailed face or something like that, that I wanted to, you know, really get in some fine detail, I personally wouldn't really find a need for a needle this small. This is an 11-round liner, so I want to go ahead and show y'all the difference here, because I do get quite a few questions about what size needle they should be using, or y'all should be using, should I say. So again, I'm just going to open this one, show y'all the difference here. So obviously y'all can see that that's a lot larger of a needle. And I just want to compare the two. So y'all can imagine in the middle between a 12 here and a 3, a 7 would be a good size, reasonable size needle for it, you know, most tattoos. I said 12, I meant 11. So I'm gonna actually go ahead and take this 11 just for today, since I have it opened. I'm gonna take my machine, put this in here. You'll find a sweet spot where it'll go all the way down. Once you're there, you're gonna press it and turn left. I'm disabled, so it shouldn't be this hard for you. All right, once we got it turned, the machine actually rotates in half itself, and that's what's gonna change the amount of needle that you have out. Next thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about, which is a very frequent question that I get, is about depth. And it's something that for a while I was scared to talk on, because I was scared to say something wrong. I was scared, you know, to not have enough information to give y'all to be helpful, but I'm just gonna give y'all what I know, what I've found, and at the end of the day, that's bound to be more helpful than nothing. You do a simple Google search of what depth should you tattoo. It's gonna say between 1.5 and 2 millimeters, and that's gonna get you, you know, you'll see the little picture right in the dermis layer, which is what you're trying to accomplish. You want to hit, you know, that layer. So that was helpful, you know, to an extent. But I still just had the hardest time figuring out, you know, I saw two different techniques. One was called like riding the tube, which is where you put just enough needle out, you know, for the depth that you're needing to go. Or, you know, you would just see that a lot of people would say it's different per artist of what you're comfortable with. And it really did take just practice and actually getting to skin and testing all of that out, because depth and, you know, tattooing and all of it really does just depend, and it really is different for each type of skin. But people's skin has different, you know, what's that word, baby?
Elasticity.
elasticity. Something that is different, you know, for each person's skin. Stretching is a huge part of tattooing, and that really is different. You know, each person's skin has different elasticity, and that will come with time, but, you know, for what they say when you're learning, you know, 1.5 to 2 millimeters, and I personally keep my needle out further than that, because for me, it's about the visual of every time that tattoo is going in skin, I like to be able to visualize how far in the needle's going, and for me, that's just how I learned. Alright, I did just switch to a 5-round liner just because it's more realistic for me to gauge like how I would actually have the needle out. But this is about as far as I would have my needle out. Because for me, it's just easier to have a visual when I'm putting, you know, the needle to skin to be able to see what I'm working with, how deep to go, and hopefully that helps to be able to, you know, actually see it. So let me get a good focus. Now that we have this all set up, the last thing I wanted to touch on is voltage. Now, again, that's a common question that I get. For me personally, I would normally sit between like a 10 voltage when I had the power source that actually like showed you the numbers you were, you know, what voltage you were at. Now with the new power source that I have, it doesn't say the number, it's just like a little knob, but if you look it up on Google, it says for line work anywhere between 7 to 9 volts or voltage, and that's not too far off from where I would sit, you know what I'm saying? I would say 8 is like a good start for, you know, if you're sitting there trying to start doing line work. I would say start at 8 voltage. Let me show y'all the fake skin. So I know that I've, again, before, like, been negative about fake skin. I learned predominantly with bananas and my skin, which I don't recommend. But I really just loved practicing on bananas. Fake skin for me is just very far off from what seems realistic. But let me pull up what I got these on Amazon for. I got a 10 piece for $15 on Amazon. I've been using them because my boyfriend is actually learning to tattoo, so he's been loving them, and they've actually been very handy to have, so maybe my opinion changed. Really quick, I did want to take 2 seconds to talk about petroleum jelly or Vaseline, and that is something that you see all of the time with tattooing. I really quickly wanted to just say what its purposes are. When I'm setting up all of my area to tattoo, I do put down some Vaseline, and then that's what I use to set my ink cups on, and that just helps them from moving or falling. So that is something that, you know, just a little tidbit that will help you out. And then the petroleum also helps reduce friction, and so it's just very helpful in having the tattoo needle slide. And then another quick little tidbit I do want to throw out there as a tip is I love to put a little bit of petroleum on the pinky of the hand that is holding the machine, and that helps your hand just glide, and it helps just the process go a lot smoother. So that is a little tip I want to give. I'll touch on this later, but or in another video, I'm not sure, but when you're putting on Vaseline on top of the tattoo, you really just need the smallest little amount, and then if you have too much, the biggest problem that you'll find is like when you have obviously some sort of ring light or a light to help with your visual, the light just bounces back really heavily off of the Vaseline if there's too much of it, and just becomes very hard to see what you're trying to do. But that is the role that Vaseline is going to play. It's very important, and I do recommend getting yourself a big old bottle of that as well. So with that being said, I'm going to take a few seconds and set up my fake skin so that I can actually show y'all a little bit of line work and give y'all a few more tips on where to begin if y'all are in the process of trying to learn tattooing. Alright guys, so we have our gloves on. I have my fake skin sitting here. I have my machine hooked up and all ready, which again, if you need a video on how to get everything working, let me know in the comments below. I have my grip tape, my needles in, my power source, and we're ready to go. So I have my petroleum, my stencil stuff, which y'all have heard me talk about 1,000 times. In this case, we don't need it. My ink, normally I recommend Dynamic. Right now I have Hawk ink. I have my ink cup over here where y'all can't see it off camera, but it's just my 2 ink cups. I like to fill up 2 at a time. And they're sitting on their petroleum, which is gonna help keep them in place. I always tattoo with a dry piece of paper towel in my opposite hand that I tattoo with. And I'm gonna show y'all why that comes in handy. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my machine. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit. I'm gonna adjust this needle. And you want the sound to be consistent humming. I'm not sure how much I'm gonna have to like lower the volume for this video, but if you can hear, it's a nice consistent hum. And then I want y'all to see how much needle I have coming out right now. Which, like I said, I like to have a little bit extra so that I can actually see what I'm going to be working with. So I have a squiggle, a line, and a heart, and I just want to spend a couple minutes today and go over a few little tips with y'all, and send y'all off on y'all's way confident to be practicing on some fake skin if y'all already have it. So I'm gonna take my middle finger, tap it in my thing of petroleum, Vaseline, whatever. I'm going to tap it on top as if it was a stencil on skin. Now, the needle moves about 100 times per second. So as you're tattooing, I want you to imagine that the slower that you're going, the more times you're allowing that needle to get in and penetrate, which is gonna obviously help it stay, not fall out, not need a touch-up. So just try to keep that in mind. So I just hit on my power source. I'm gonna dip it in my ink. And then every time I dip my needle in ink, I take this dry piece of paper towel that I told you I keep in my left hand, and I go like this. You'll see me do it every single time before I go back in. And that's just gonna get off the extra ink, which is gonna eliminate ink pooling, which would happen if you had a bunch of extra ink and you went to tattoo or you went to place your needle on skin. All of a sudden, you're not gonna see anything and you're gonna lose visibility instantly because you haven't wiped off that extra ink. So I'm gonna go ahead. Again, if you do a quick Google search, they'll say that you should be holding your pen at, I think they say between, last time I remember looking, it was like a 90 degree angle. I don't know if I hold mine a certain way because of, again, I have to make adjustments because of my disability and what's comfortable for my wrist, you know, when it comes to holding the weight. So I'm not going to say anything about the correct way to hold it. I do what's comfortable for my wrist due to the weight distribution. So I have my petroleum. I hold mine as if I hold a pen. I always get eyesight of where the needle's gonna land. So right now, I'm down here looking at where this needle's gonna be, and that's why you'll see my head is at this angle. And I'm gonna go ahead. Tap. And I'm just gonna keep going. Now, when I was doing this whole journey of trying to find, you know, the right ways to do things, I saw somebody say that, you know, if you have a certain style of drawing, for example, tattoo how you draw. So for me, I don't find myself doing consistent, huge, long lines. I'll do a line, and then I'll wipe it, and I'll just see how we're doing. So now I'm going to go ahead and wipe. And you'll see what we have. So then for me, if there's any lines that are not perfectly straight, I'll go through and I'll color it in as if I'm coloring in a perfect line. You know what I'm saying? So if I do a line at first and it's, you know, got a little bit of a wiggle, well, that's no big deal, because then I'm going to go in and I'm just going to go do-do-do-do-do, and I'll perfect it. So then if you take petroleum, that's going to help you get a good visual. And then you'll see that because I'm using the same amount of pressure, the same amount of depth, it's all the same thickness. Now, if I were to go, okay, let me start here and go this thickness, and then I'm going to go really light, and then I'm going to go harder again, and then I'm going to go light. You're going to see that that's not going to be a consistent line. You know, it squiggles, it's thinner here, so you have to keep the same amount of pressure. So I'm going to start with this line, and I'm going to do the whole line. See, I'll go back down if I feel that the thickness has gotten off. Okay, maybe I'll jump up to the opposite side. Okay, and then I'm gonna go ahead and wipe. And then if you see that there's this little part in the middle that's a little bit thinner, so maybe I'll start back at the top. And just start evening that out. And then you want to keep checking. Obviously it's a little bit dirty, but you can see nothing's gone through, so you're not going too deep. And that is obviously the perk of these, you know, fake skins, is learning depth. So I'm going to go ahead and do this heart. For me, with hearts, I'm always going to start at the bottom. And I'm just focusing on this line the whole time. And then maybe I'll jump. And then maybe I'll jump back. Okay, I'm gonna get some ink. And then as always, I'm gonna... And this hand doesn't know what to do, because normally you'd be stretching skin, so you have to always keep that in mind, that your left hand's gonna have a job. Another negative of these fake skins is trying to wipe them. But, you know, I hope that this is a good example of how to sit and practice. So let's say I just do a really quick line. Okay, so I didn't pay attention to depth, speed, nothing, didn't give the needle time to penetrate, and it's non-existent. Now let's go over here and let's say, well, shoot, let me try to go slower and be a little more thoughtful in what I'm doing. And get some petroleum to help you see, but then, you know, you're gonna see the difference.
All right, guys, so I hope that that little hands-on visual was helpful. I hope that this video was helpful. Leave any thoughts you have in the comments, any specific questions you have in the comments. Thank you so much for being here. If you're new from TikTok, or if you've been here, thank you so much, guys, for watching. I love y'all, and I will see y'all in the next one.